It is once again time. SmackDown. Oh, sorry, I forgot the everybody. Everybody. SmackDown for September 7th, 2012. What the hell was David Otunga doing in the main event? But I digress. So we kicked off the show with, and basically they were bitching and moaning that the Brogue Kick should be banned from fucking the WWE. And I don't understand what the hell the point of this was. I mean, they really haven't put any emphasis on the fact that the Brogue Kick is unstoppable and unbeatable and, you know, it's gonna end people's careers. So why is it all of a sudden this fucking world's most dangerous move that we have to have it banned? Apparently now it breaks necks. Yeah, scary, right? It used to just be a signature mover. Not even the finisher. It used to be just a signature. Now it's deadly. Booker T comes out and he gives all the power in the world to the fans. So I guess we're going back to power of the people here. Because Booker T asked them if he should ban it. They say no, and he listens. So if the fans all told you to jump off of... I know you heard this cliche before, alright? But fuck off. Fuck you. I'm Spider-Man. I can do what I want. If the fans told Booker T to jump off a bridge, I'm sure Booker T would, because that's how much of a puppet he is to the WWE universe. The most randomest tag team in the history of the WWE, Rey Mysterio and Sin Cara, this makes no sense. They have nothing in common. They go one-on-one with The Miz and Cody Gay. Again, Miz jobbing. Is it bad? No, because of the hometown hero thing. But it sucks because the guy's Intercontinental Champion and he's jobbing to two vanilla midgets in masks that can't even show their own faces. It's not to say it's horrible because Rey Mysterio actually has credibility, but when you're jobbing to Sin Cara, your career is going down the tube. It's stupid because we actually thought he was going to be relevant again after he won the Intercontinental Championship. So we got a match between Zack Ryder and Daniel Bryan, although there was a funny ass part in the match where Daniel Bryan and Zack Ryder actually hugged. I won't lie, I cracked up when I saw that. That was too funny. By the way, this fucking ref is a piece of shit, and he'll be lucky if I don't see him on the streets one day and beat the fuck out of him, because this cost me points in the tournament. Daniel Bryan beat Zack Ryder. He made him tap out, and he reversed the decision. Why the fuck would you reverse the decision? Like, this is Tensai all over again. This has happened a billion times before. Why is it all of a sudden a rule that a heel can't beat up a face after the match is over? Like, okay, they reversed the decision before, and then they decided to change it again where it doesn't matter anymore. And now they decided to make it pick it up back up as a rule again? What the fuck is this shit? This is the stupidest rule that I've ever heard or watched. Damian Sandow comes out, he cuts a promo. Randy Orton comes out randomly because they're stuck in a random match, so that just forces Randy Orton to cut off Damian Sandow. Fuck Randy Orton. And you know what? I wish Damian Sandow had defeated him. You know, but I was pissed off because in this match, Randy Orton ended up winning and he ended up looking strong. And the one thing that really pissed me off, Dolph Ziggler was the heel that got saved by the other heel. But, I mean, it makes sense since they're feuding and yada, yada, yada. But, you know, putting my personal opinion and Marxism, if you want to call it that, into this saga, I wish Dolph Ziggler had been the one jobbing and made to look like a bitch and Damian Sandow looking strong. Because Damian Sandow is still a star that they need to build up. But just by having him get buried by Randy Orton, yeah, that's not going to help his career. In fact, he might end up like Kofi Kingston. So there were like 50 promos with David Otunga backstage bitching at Booker T saying the Brogue Kick should be banned. Again, a most deadly move. I'm surprised he doesn't rally to get the Cobra banned. That's a pretty vicious maneuver. That's pretty dangerous. So instead of banning it, he ends up making the main event David Otunga versus Sheamus. Okay, this is good because they're finally putting the world champion in the main event. You know, not that the world champion deserves to be in the main event, because the guy's not even over anymore. I mean, he fucking sucks. He's a disgrace to the world championship. I'm sorry, Sheamus. I don't even hate you that much anymore. But the fact that you can't get a pop to save your life, and you put on the same act for 5 months straight, your shit's getting old, and you're a disgrace to the world championship. They really need to take the belt off of him at Night of Champions. They really need to put the belt on Alberto Del Rio, not only to keep the feud fresh, and not only to take the title off Sheamus, give him time to regroup, maybe to, like, revitalize his character. Not only that, but Alberto Del Rio, he's over. So he gets a lot of heat. He deserves the world championship. And not only that, but it's also to bring justice to this fucking feud that's gone on for 50 years. So in my huge markout moment of the night, I didn't see this coming. You know why? I did not look at spoilers. I had nothing. And I marked the fuck. I nearly threw my computer into my fan upstairs, which is above the ceiling, which is clearly impossible, but that just shows you how hard I threw it and how excited I was when I saw Wade Barrett return. Like, not only was that a marked out moment because he came back and he squashed Yoshitatsu, but because of the promo afterwards. See, the whole time I was thinking, fuck, I hope they don't have him do what Brodus Clay did and just squash 50 million people every week without having any type of an advancement. Then, after the match, he cuts a promo, he says, "Oi, being put in squash matches absolutely appalls me. And if I'm not inserted into the title picture sooner rather than later, I will do something to make things very interesting around here." So basically, I don't know if he's gonna go around attacking people, important people, or if he's just gonna just be automatically placed in the title picture again. This was huge. And I seriously cannot wait to see what Wade Barrett has in store for me. Finally, some motivation to watch SmackDown, because I really haven't had that much motivation other than Caitlyn to watch SmackDown since AJ left, so that just tells you. So the PTP defeated Primo and Epico, which was a damn shame. More points that could have happened lost. And why are the primetime players number one contenders again? What's the point? Why wouldn't you just throw the belts on them at SummerSlam if you wanted them to be in the title picture for so damn long? Like, seriously, I don't understand what the hell the point of having them lose at SummerSlam was. That it would have been the perfect time to put the belts on them. This reminds me of the Nexus, only it's not as drastic. They should have won at SummerSlam, but since they did it, it seems like the WWE is desperate to, like, make up for their error and do it in as quick a way as possible. The Nexus, it was that huge elimination match on Raw where Wade Barrett pinned, was it Randy Orton or John Cena? It was Randy Orton or John Cena. This time around, it's the primetime players with the tag team title. So, it's like with Alberto Del Rio, they should have put the belt on them already. Even though this hasn't lasted as long, they should have had the belt already. So, this is awesome news. Teddy Long is going to advise Booker T to make Dolph Ziggler versus Randy Orton at Night of Champions. Last time I checked, neither one of them was a champion. Neither one of them, it should be really relevant, considering one of them just came off of doing drugs but was pushed to the moon, and the other one isn't that strong on the microphone. Why are these guys in a match at Night of Champions? Not only that, putting my differences aside, we've seen this match like 5 times over the past 2 weeks. Is there a necessity to put this on pay-per-view? Is someone going to be like, fuck, dude, they've been having like a best of 5 series. Fifth match is going to happen on a pay-per-view. I have to buy the pay-per-view. I have to see who wins this epic feud that I just can't miss. Feud means nothing. Okay, put Dolph Ziggler's money in the bank on the line. Maybe I'll be interested, you know. I mean, I won't care who wins. Well, if Randy Orton wins, I will rage. And I might become a Dolph Ziggler fan after that. I mean, other than that, I have no motivation to watch this garbage. Main event, Sheamus defeated David Otunga. Yeah, Booker T comes out in the match to tell Sheamus that he can't use the bro kick. In the middle of the match. And Sheamus still ends up winning. With all these distractions, Alberto Del Rio out, Booker T telling him the bro kick can't be used, he still wins. Okay, I get it. David Otunga's a joke. He sucks. He's not supposed to win matches. He's just supposed to have a stupid character. But damn. I mean, for Sheamus to overcome all that, who's to say he can't overcome a fucking earthquake, rain, hail, and being struck by lightning to defeat Alberto Del Rio in a match? This is seriously, if they were to literally do that in a kayfabe form in a match, I would not be surprised one bit. Look, that's how stupidly they booked Sheamus, and that's how sick I am of them booking Sheamus like that. Again, I don't hate Sheamus, I hate how he's being booked. So this episode of SmackDown was pretty damn awesome. Why? Wade Barrett's return? Yeah, that was why it was awesome. Anyway, this has been the other guy for the MTO Reviews, your SmackDown review, yada, 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 blah, 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 good, and... Bye.